Aga Khan University Hospital in Nairobi has been providing health services in East Africa for the last 63 years since its inception in 1958. With a bed capacity of 300 patients, the hospital is not only ranked among the best health facilities in East Africa, but also in Africa. Rashid Kalani, the hospital chief executive officer, explained the role of the hospital besides providing of quality health services.
This hospital is just not a hospital. It's an institution of learning. As the name suggests, it's a university hospital. So we are not just providing care to the patients, but we are also teaching the future physicians as well.
Every year, the hospital receives over 700,000 patients from across Africa, and Kalani explains the inflows.
People want first is convenience, and we are convenient. We are 1 hour's flight away or 2 hours flight away rather than traveling for 18-24 hours. And the second and more important is the quality of care. If they are satisfied with the quality of care, with the clinical outcomes, then the trust is built up. And I think we are playing our part and we are building that trust. So people in DRC, people in Uganda, people in Ethiopia and other parts of Africa, they don't have to travel to outside of continent. That is our goal.
He also explained some of the ailments that the hospital has specialized in the recent past.
We have over 120 specialists. They are working full-time with us. Because we are a university hospital, we are just not employing doctors. We have a faculty model, and we have 120 of them in various disciplines. When we talk about medicine as an example, there are subspecialties in medicine, nephrology, cardiology, neurology, infectious disease, and so on and so forth.
With the recent trends in modern health technology, Kalani explains how they are moving up to speed with the latest state-of-the-art technology in handling all cases.
Increasingly, the healthcare is dependent on good diagnostics. If your diagnostics are accurate, your care is accurate. If your diagnostic is bad or poor, then the care is poor. So we have invested a significant amount of money, and we continue to invest a lot in technology. Just to give you a couple of examples, we became the first hospital in East Africa to get the PET CT and the cyclotron. PET CT and cyclotron, as you would know, is an advanced cancer diagnostic equipment.
The hospital was recently accredited by the Global Healthcare Quality Accreditation Organization and the Joint Commission International for their quality health services.
Every equipment that we buy, every individual that we employ, every policy that we roll out, it is important that the patient is at the center of it. To give patients the confidence, we embarked upon quality journeys, quality accreditations. So in 2013, we became the first hospital in East Africa to be accredited by Joint Commission International. So if someone wants to Google it, what is the gold standard when it comes to quality accreditations, the JCIA will come at the top. So we are the hospital that got quality accreditation by JCIA, and there are over 1200 measurable elements that we are audited upon. Then in 2011, our laboratory services became accredited by SANAS, which is a South African accreditation body. In 2018, our laboratory services went ahead and became accredited by the College for American Pathologists, which is again a very goal, it's a gold standard. And it's a journey. In 2020, we became the Center of Excellence for Heart Attack, again by Joint Commission International, USA. In 2021, in the midst of COVID, we went through an audit. It was a very rigorous audit. And then we became the first hospital in Africa to become the Center of Excellence for the Acute Stroke Program, again by the Joint Commission.
Kalani explains that accreditations are as a result of the hospital's outstanding services rendered to clients.
And why these accreditations are important? Because the patient and the patient's safety is at the center of it. And so when the patient comes to Aga Khan University Hospital, they can be assured that they will get the best quality of care that they would get in North America or in Europe or in Asia.
To extend their services to the rest of East African region, Aga Khan University Hospital is yet to construct a world-class hospital in Kampala, the capital city of Uganda.
We will be very soon starting construction of a tertiary care hospital as well. Again, it will be a teaching hospital. It will not just be a hospital to treat patients, but it will be a teaching hospital. We will be teaching and the future doctors for Uganda, and hopefully those doctors will Once they graduate, they will stay in Uganda and provide the good quality of service.
This is in addition to the already existing 4 Aga Khan Hospital-affiliated clinics already in Kampala. Every year, the Ugandan government spends over 300 billion shillings in treatment of its officials abroad. However, upon completion of the Aga Khan University Hospital, the expenditure on international referrals is likely to be reduced to more than half. The hospital in Kampala will also provide extended skills and knowledge to Ugandan health practitioners, especially the students.
So all these programs that we are offering in Kenya, with the passage of time, hopefully we will be able to take to Uganda as well and offer the same services, not only clinical services, but the education programs to Uganda as well.